Good afternoon, class. Today we'll start with the new topic, that is tables, hyperlinks, forms in HTML. So in today's lecture, what we are going to see is how to create tables, hyperlinks in the HTML. So what is HTML first? Can you all recall? You all must have started learning HTML since long back. So HTML stands for hyperlink. Hypertext markup language. So this HTML is a language which is not case sensitive, which is used for creating websites. So the software required for creating website is just a text editor, that is a notepad and a web browser. Web browser is what? Web browser is a software through which you can access the websites. So to create a website, we use this HTML language. So in that, today we are going to emphasis on how to create tables in HTML and how the table looks like. See, the table is nothing but tabular representation of data in form of rows and columns. So row here stands for horizontal line that represents a record in a table, and column stands for vertical line that contains particular type of values, and the value inside the table is nothing but a intersection of row and column is nothing but a cell. Okay, so here we are going to see how to use table. See, there's a table tag. The sub tags of table tag are tr tag, th tag. Tr stands for table row, th stands for table heading, td stands for table data. So tr tag here is used to create one horizontal row. In that row, you can add multiple columns. So for adding the columns, for giving the heading for in your table, you can use th tag. To insert a data inside that column, you will use which tag? Td tag. You can see your tr tag stands for table row and will insert a new row in the table. Td tag stands for table data, will insert a cell in the row to store the values. Caption tag is used to give the caption heading to your table. Th tag stands for table heading. Now we will jump towards the attributes of table tag. Which all are the attributes of the table tag? Attributes are nothing but the properties of the table tag which are used to specify the appearance of the table. So the attributes of table tag are like border, border color, background, cell spacing, cell padding, alignment, width and height. So border here is used to place a border around the table and each cell. Border color is used to set the color of the border. BG color is used to change the background color of your table. Background attribute is used to set up image as in background image. Cell spacing, it gives amount of space between the cells. Cell padding, it gives the space between the cell border and the content of the cell. Alignment, it is the attribute which is used to align the table either a left, right or center. Height and width are used to specify the height and width of the cell. Okay, for example, can you see the example over here? HTML head title. In table tag, we have used all its attributes: border, border color, BG color, cell spacing, cell padding, line, height and width. We have set all the values for all these attributes. So you can see the coding and the output in front of it, which will make it clear. See, the border color is blue, the background color is green. There is a spacing in between each cell, spacing in between the content and the cell border. Okay, now we will turn towards the attributes of the table data tag. So the attributes of TD tag are align, This attribute is used to set the position of the text in a cell. Width. This attribute is used to specify the width of a cell. BG color is used to change the background color of each cell. If you want to change an individual color of a cell, you can use BG color attribute. If you want to change alignment of an individual data inside the cell, you will use align attribute of TD tag. If you want to change the image of a particular cell, you will use background attribute. Now, students, you can see on your screen the coding for TD tag, CTD tag, and all its alignments attributes, that is align, width, BG color, okay, and the output over here. See, we have just changed the background color of a particular cell. We have changed background image of the particular cell. So you can do this by using the attributes of TD tag. Now we will turn towards table head, table body, table foot. See, if you want to give a specific property for a specific row, say the heading of the table, then you will use table head tag. This table head tag is used to create horizontal header over the complete width of a table. Table body tag is used to create groups of rows in a table body. Table foot, it indicates at the bottom of the table if you want to set the particular properties of a table. So for example, if you want to give pink color for your last row, you will use table foot tag. And the sub tag of table foot tag will be TR tag. As you can see in front of your screen, see, there is table head tag having BG color purple. Inside that we have enclosed one TR tag. We have closed table head tag. Then again we have started table body tag, in which we have given background color as pink. Then we have started with table foot tag, where we have given background color as white. So likewise, you can set row wise, you can set the background colors. So table head, table body, and table foot. Now we will turn towards the next attributes of your table tag, that is call spacing, row spacing. See, suppose you want to merge two cells and you want to make it as a one cell. So for merging two cells and making it as in a one cell, you can use row span. It is used to merge two or more rows. And say if you want to combine two columns and you want to make one column, you will use which attribute? That is call span. So this is nothing but merging of the cells. We will see an example of merging of cells. So TH, suppose you want to do the merging of two rows and you want to make it as a one row, you will use row span. Row span is equal to 2 or row span is equal to 3. So respectively 3 rows will get merged and which will form one row. If you say TD call span is equal to 2, that means it is combining two columns and making it as a one column. So you can use row span, call span, and row span. Now, do you remember, if you click on something in a website where you get a hand as in a pointer, it means it is holding address of another page. So what is it called? It is called as hyperlink. So hyperlink can be any text or image that takes you to another page or a file on a website or on the internet. Here, the tag which is used for creating hyperlink is anchor tag. This anchor tag defines a hyperlink. The attribute of anchor tag is href, that is hyperlink references. So this hyperlink references, it refers to the full web address of the linked resource, which could be a document, multimedia file. Okay, the another attribute of anchor tag is target. So where actually you want to open the document or a website. So it is used with frames and defines where to open the document. And next one is the name attribute of anchor tag, which is used to define the named anchor. There are two types of hyperlink. One is internal hyperlink, another one is external hyperlink. So what is internal hyperlink? Internal hyperlink is used to link a part of same document. An external hyperlink is used to link part of same document, and external linking is used to link one document with another document. So we will see here the example of external hyperlink and internal hyperlink. Okay, so see, I have just created a hyperlink of Mickey Mouse. The moment you click on a Mickey Mouse, a cartoon, you will get the cartoon. Actually, I have shown the picture of Donald Duck and written there Mickey Mouse. So the points which you need to remember from this unit is table, that is table tag, TH tag, TR tag, TD tag, table head, table body, table foot, call span, row span, cell spacing, cell padding, hyperlink, anchor tag. Okay. Students, now you are requested to go through the topic table. You have to try to solve the exercise of this topic. And if you have any doubt, just put your queries on the WhatsApp group. Okay, have a good day. Good afternoon, class. Today we'll start with the new topic, that is tables, hyperlinks, forms in HTML. So in today's lecture, what we are going to see is how to create tables, hyperlinks in the HTML. So what is HTML first? Can you all recall? You all must have started learning HTML since long back. So HTML stands for hyperlink, hypertext markup language. So this HTML is a language which is not case sensitive, which is used for creating websites. So the software required for creating website is just a text editor, that is a notepad and a web browser. Web browser is what? Web browser is a software through which you can access the websites. So to create a website, we use this HTML language. So in that, today we are going to emphasis on how to create tables in HTML and how the table looks like. See, the table is nothing but tabular representation of data in form of rows and columns. So row here stands for horizontal line that represents a record in a table, and column stands for vertical line that contains particular type of values, and the value inside the table is nothing but a intersection of row and column is nothing but a cell. Okay, so here we are going to see how to use table. See, there's a table tag. The subtags of table tag are tr tag, th tag. Tr stands for table row, th stands for table heading, td stands for table data. So tr tag here is used to create one horizontal row. In that row, you can add multiple columns. So for adding the columns, for giving the heading for in your table, you can use th tag. To insert a data inside that column, you will use which tag? TD tag. You can see your TR tag stands for table row and will insert a new row in the table. TD tag stands for table data, will insert a cell in the row to store the values. Caption tag is used to give the caption heading to your table. TH tag stands for table heading. Now we will jump towards the attributes of table tag. Which all are the attributes of the table tag? Attributes are nothing but the properties of the table tag which are used to specify the appearance of the table. So the attributes of table tag are like border, border color, background, cell spacing, cell padding, alignment, width and height. So border here is used to place a border around the table and each cell. Border color is used to set the color of the border. BG color is used to change the background color of your table. Background attribute is used to set up image as in background image. Cell spacing, it gives amount of space between the cells. Cell padding, it gives the space between the cell border and the content of the cell. Alignment, it is the attribute which is used to align the table either a left, right or center. Height and width are used to specify the height and width of the cell. Okay, for example, can you see the example over here? HTML head title. In table tag, we have used all its attributes: border, border color, BG color, cell spacing, cell padding, line, height and width. We have set all the values for all its attributes. So you can see the coding and the output in front of it, which will make it clear. See, the border color is blue, the background color is green. There is a spacing in between each cell, spacing in between the content and the cell border. Okay, now we will turn towards the attributes of the table data tag. So the attributes of TD tag are align, This attribute is used to set the position of the text in a cell. Width. This attribute is used to specify the width of a cell. BG color is used to change the background color of each cell. If you want to change an individual color of a cell, you can use BG color attribute. If you want to change alignment of an individual data inside the cell, you will use align attribute of TD tag. If you want to change the image of a particular cell, you will use background attribute. Now, students, you can see on your screen the coding for TD tag, CTD tag, and all its alignments attributes, that is align, width, BG color, okay, and the output over here. See, we have just changed the background color of a particular cell. We have changed background image of the particular cell. So you can do this by using the attributes of TD tag. Now we will turn towards table head, table body, table foot. See, if you want to give a specific property for a specific row, say the heading of the table, then you will use table head tag. This table head tag is used to create horizontal header over the complete width of a table. Table body tag is used to create groups of rows in a table body. Table foot, it indicates at the bottom of the table if you want to set the particular properties of a table. So for example, if you want to give pink color for your last row, you will use table foot tag. And the sub tag of table foot tag will be TR tag. As you can see in front of your screen, see, there is table head tag having BG color purple. Inside that we have enclosed one TR tag. We have closed table head tag. Then again we have started table body tag, in which we have given background color as pink. Then we have started with table foot tag, where we have given background color as white. So likewise, you can set row wise, you can set the background color. So table head, table body, and table foot. Now we will turn towards the next attributes of your table tag, that is call spacing, row spacing. See, suppose you want to merge two cells and you want to make it as a one cell. So for merging two cells and making it as in a one cell, you can use row span. It is used to merge two or more rows. And say if you want to combine two columns and you want to make one column, you will use which attribute? That is call span. So this is nothing but merging of the cells. We will see an example of merging of cells. So TH, suppose you want to do the merging of two rows and you want to make it as a one row, you will use row span. Row span is equal to 2 or row span is equal to 3. So respectively 3 rows will get merged and which will form one row. If you say TD call span is equal to 2, that means it is combining two columns and making it as a one column. So you can use row span, call span, and row span. Now, do you remember, if you click on something in a website where you get a hand as in a pointer, it means it is holding address of another page. So what is it called? It is called as hyperlink. So hyperlink can be any text or image that takes you to another page or a file on a website or on the internet. Here, the tag which is used for creating hyperlink is anchor tag. This anchor tag defines a hyperlink. The attribute of anchor tag is href, that is hyperlink references. So this hyperlink references, it refers to the full web address of the linked resource, which could be a document, multimedia file. Okay, the another attribute of anchor tag is target. So where actually you want to open the document or a website. So it is used with frames and defines where to open the document. And next one is the name attribute of anchor tag, which is used to define the named anchor. There are two types of hyperlink. One is internal hyperlink, another one is external hyperlink. So what is internal hyperlink? Internal hyperlink is used to link a part of same document. An external hyperlink is used to link part of same document, and external linking is used to link one document with another document. So we will see here the example of external hyperlink and internal hyperlink. Okay. So see, I have just created a hyperlink of Mickey Mouse. The moment you click on a Mickey Mouse, a cartoon, you will get the cartoon. Actually, I have shown the picture of Donald Duck and written there Mickey Mouse. So the points which you need to remember from this unit is table, that is table tag, TH tag, TR tag, TD tag, table head, table body, table foot, call span, row span, cell spacing, cell padding, hyperlink, anchor tag. Okay. Students, now you are requested to go through the topic table. You have to try to solve the exercise of this topic. And if you have any doubt, just put your queries on the WhatsApp group. Okay, have a good day.